Let's create a manager object for our user profile. Because we're customizing Django's user model, we need to teach Django how to use our new user profile model. We do this by creating a manager object that goes with our user profile model, and we reference it here where we define objects as the user profile manager, or user profile manager as the objects. So let's create our user profile manager. We start by importing Django's base user manager class. This is the class that Django uses by default. So we're just going to use the same class and we're going to build on top of it and customize it to tell Django how to use our new model correctly. So let's import the base user manager class by typing from django.contrib.auth.models import base user manager. Okay, so now that we've imported it, let's go ahead and build our manager class. Start by typing class user profile manager. And let's inherit from the base user manager that we just added. Let's create a doc string that says helps Django work with our custom user model. All right, so you need to make sure that the user profile manager name is the same name as you gave here in objects. So that needs to match exactly. All right, so now let's define a function that tells Django how to create a user with our custom user model. So type def create underscore user, and we're gonna add the parameters self name or self email name and password. And we're gonna add a doc string here that says creates a new user profile object. Okay, so now we need to write the logic that creates a new user in the system. The first thing we're gonna do is check that they've provided an email address. The email is a required field in the system, so we need to make sure that if they try and call this without an email address, we show them an error message. So we're gonna check the email exists, we're gonna check if it doesn't exist. So if not email, and if not email, so if they didn't provide an email, then raise a value error. And we'll give it the message, users must have an email address. All right, so when you say if not a field here, if you say if not this variable name email, then what it does is it returns true if it's none or false. So if they provide a blank email or they put false in there, then it's going to raise this value error to say the users must have an email address. All right, so now we're going to do something called normalizing the email address. Okay, so the email address, normalize email address is a function that normalizes the email address in the system. So that means it converts all of the characters to lowercase, or all of the characters of the domain name to lowercase. So that way all the email addresses are standardized in the system. Do this by typing email equals self.normalize email email. Okay, so now that we normalize the email, let's actually create a new user profile object. Do this by typing user equals self.model email equals email. So we're gonna create a new version of ourselves, which is this user profile. And we're gonna assign the email, which is this field here, to the email, which we've normalized, and the name to the name, which the user provided in the create user function call. All right, so now the last thing to do is to set the user's password. So we're gonna type user.setPassword. Password. So we're going to call this set password function of our user profile model, and we're going to set the password to the password they provided here. The reason we don't just provide the password here is because this set password function will encrypt the password for us. So it basically converts the string that they provided as a password to a hash, which is stored in the database. So the user's actual clear text password is never actually stored in the system. This is best practice for creating a secure system, because if anyone does compromise the database, then they can't actually see the user's clear text passwords. All they can see is the user's hash. Okay, so now let's save the model by typing user.save, and we're gonna use using equals self.db, means use the same DB that we created with the user profile manager, and we're gonna return the user object. Okay, so that's the create user function. It checks that they provided an email. It normalizes the email that they provided to make sure all the domain characters are lowercase. It creates a new user object, sets the password in the object, and it saves it, and then it returns the object. So the second function we need to create on our user profile manager is the function that tells Django how to create a super user. Okay, so we're going to define a new function called create super user. So type def for define create super user. All right, so we're going to give it the parameters self, email, name, and password. So more or less the same here, except we're not going to put a default as none on password because we're going to require a password for a super user. All right, so let's create a doc string here that says creates and saves a new super user with given details. All right, so we can actually use the create user function we just created to create a standard user and then change it to make that user a super user. A super user is just a user in the system that has full control over everything. So it's like an administrator user. Let's call the function we created and assign it to a variable called user. So user equals self.create user. And we're going to pass in the same fields that we did here. So we're going to pass in the email, the name, and the password that was provided when we called the create super user function. Okay, so after we've created a user, we need to assign two variables to the user. We need to assign is super user, or we need to set is super user to true and is staff to true. So type user.isSuperUser equals true, and user.isStaff equals true. All right, so now that we've done that, we can save the user model. So user.save using equals self.db, and then finally return the user object. Okay, so that's all we need to create in the user profile manager to tell Django how to use our custom user model. All it needs is the create user, so it knows how to create a new standard user, and the create super user, so it knows how to create an administrator user in the system. So that's how you create a user profile manager in Django. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video useful, and I'll see you in the next lesson.